popping YouTube. It's your boy Q the Flu back in the building with another video, man. Hey, and we following up on you know, release from last week. But of course, before we get into any of that, hit that subscribe button, hit that notification bell, hit that like button, and holler at your boy in the comments. You know the vibes. I do talk back. And without further ado, let's go ahead and get right to it. So, hey man, I wanted to kind of, you know, double up, man. You know, a couple of days has passed, the dust has settled, man. Everybody got, you know, their Valentine's Day on and, you know, so forth and so forth. You know what I'm saying? And yeah, you know, them Carmine Sixes things, them things definitely dropped this past weekend, man. And, you know, I wanted to come to the table and just kind of, you know, give my thoughts about, you know, Pinkgate, man. You know what I'm saying? If you don't know by now, you've been living under the rock, you know that, you know, a lot of people weren't able to get their hands on the Carmine Sixes, you know, due to a lot of the defects, man, the pink defects. And a lot of stores, you know, they're in stock, you know, being sliced in half, having to ship pairs back, you know, because, you know, the men's soles is just going crazy with the pink wave, man. You know what I'm saying? If you remember a couple of years ago, you know, we had the infra pink, you know, white, you know, infrared sixes. And you know, everybody was kind of hating on the black infrared sixes from 2014 because, you know, the pink infrared. But now we got whole pinked out soles out here now, which is really unfortunate because, you know, the Carmine Sixes, especially with that Nike Air on the back, you know, people have been definitely anticipating this shoe for years, man. I remember back in 2014 when, you know, the last retro came out. The release for those joints were just as crazy as they are for this new this new release. And not only that, but you know, this new joint got the, you know, it's back in true form with the Nike Air on the back, man. So people had to have that shoe, man. But unfortunately, man, you know, the pink soles, you know, that ain't a good look. So a lot of those pairs are going back. You know, I'm kind of showing y'all, you know, just kind of video, man, just really looking at just how bad, you know, some of these pairs were. You know, that would kind of shift out in the back room, man. You know, the pink is pink. Now, my pair, you know, that I got, you know, a slight tint, you know what I'm saying? But, you know, not as pink as some of them can get. And you can see, you know, for yourself, you know, pairs, man, really put up, man. Anybody, you know, just, it's just crazy, you know what I'm saying? Now, in my opinion, you know, there's still some hope for, you know, some of y'all that just really got to have to show your collection. If you were able to get a relatively clean pair, I'm advising you to kind of hold on to those because I don't see this shoe re-releasing out here. You know what I'm saying? Like, typically, if you know, you know, you know, Nike will go ahead, grab these defective pairs and put them in the outlet mall, you know, the Nike outlets, and then you'll be able to go and get them for, like, you know, the discount or whatever. But, you know, with something like, you know, an issue like this cosmetic, whereas it's you know, nobody's sending these pairs back into a factory to be repainted to them, be resold. That's a lot of extra money to kind of put into this shoe. You know what I'm saying? We already living in the midst of a pandemic. You know, you got people barely wanting you to try on stuff in the stores, let alone shipping a shoe all the way back to a factory, repainting it, and then resending it to stores. It's just a lot of time, a lot of money, a lot of wasted effort, you know what I'm saying, for a release that's just passed, especially when, you know, we got a new sneaker release every other week. You know what I'm saying? So, you know, if you ain't got this shoe by now, you know, and you know, I advise you to go ahead, get your hands on, you know, a pair any way you can, because, you know, the pairs that were kind of released out there might mess around to be the only pairs that you actually see, because, you know, I can't see Nike selling the pink shoe, you know, not even in the outlets, you know, for some of y'all that's just hoping that that's going to be the case, man. So, I really think that they're going to end up scrapping all of these, you know, defective pairs, and that's just going to, it's going to be one of the more limited general release sneakers ever. You know what I'm saying? And so, you know, up to your boy Q the Flu, I'm letting y'all know, go ahead, hit your StockX. If you got lucky, you know, got a pair from your local mall, or your local mall might be having a couple of pairs, you know, just kind of sitting out there, hurry up and grab them up, because it's going to get real scary, you know, in a few months, man, for those Carmine Sixes, man. Especially because they did it the right way. But y'all let me know y'all opinions on this matter, man. Of course, you know, as always, man, it's your boy Q the Flu. Like, comment, subscribe, you know the vibes, as we proceed to give you what you need for another episode of FGTV. And like that, Carmine Sixes, we out.
Peace. This Chicago.